Hi, and welcome to the sixth part of the Simple Character Controller series. In the last video, we talked about making your character jump. Depending on what kind of game you're making, you might want to give your character the ability to double jump. Start by opening up your player controller script and let's add a few new variables. Let's start with a simple private variable of type int and call it number of jumps. Now, this could easily be a boolean called something like hasDoubleJumped that is set to true whenever you have double jumped to not allow for another jump until you have landed. But what if you want your character to be able to do a triple jump? Let's also create a serialized private variable of type int and call it maxNumber of jumps. I will set it to 2, but you can easily change this in the editor later. Now, in our jump method where we check if we are grounded, let's also check if we can do a double jump. We do this in the same if statement with 2 ampersands by checking if number of jumps is more than or equal to max number of jumps. And if it is, we have already double jumped, so we can just return here. Let's type number of jumps plus plus, meaning we add 1 to our variable after every jump. This is just shorthand for and gives the same result as number of jumps equals number of jumps plus 1, or number of jumps plus equals 1. Now we need to reset the number of jumps variable as soon as we have landed. One simple way to do this is with a coroutine. Down here, after the jump method, let's type private ienumerator and call it wait for landing. What we essentially want to do is wait for the character to land and then set the number of jumps variable back to 0. So let's type yield return new wait until is grounded. I think this does the same as while and negated is grounded yield return null. But I find this much easier to read. And after that, set the number of jumps to 0. This will just wait for the character to be grounded again before resetting the variable. However, if we call this from the jump method now, the character will still be grounded as this method gets fired. So right before checking if it is grounded, we are going to type yield return new wait until opening and closing parentheses, an arrow operator, and a negated is grounded. This means that we are first waiting until the character is no longer grounded, meaning the character has jumped and is in the air, and right after that we are waiting until it is grounded again. Now, in the jump method, we don't want this to fire every time we jump, so let's first check if number of jumps is 0, meaning it's our first jump, and then we can start a coroutine and wait for landing. And now, instead of velocity plus equals jump power, let's remove the plus sign here. Otherwise, your character jumping might feel very uneven. Now, let's finally jump back into Unity to test this out. With double jumps, I find my previous jump power of 4 to be a bit aggressive, so I will set it to 3 for now. Hit play and make sure your character is double jumping. We can now jump with the spacebar, and while in the air, pressing the spacebar makes the character jump again. Another thing I like to do is make the second jump less powerful, so let's try this in the player controller script. This might not be to your taste, but if we divide jump power by the number of jumps, the second jump will be less powerful. So the first jump will get 3, which is our jump power divided by number of jumps 1, resulting in 3. However, the second time we jump we will get 3, divided by number of jumps, which is now 2, returning a value of 1.5. For this project, however, I will keep the first option here. And there you have it, a simple way to have your character doing double jumps. If you want to allow for a third jump, you can just change the number of jumps variable in the player controller component. The project is updated on GitHub, and you will find a link down in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.